It's Māori Language Week, so what better time to take a moment and appreciate Māori customs and culture?
Yeah, it's great to see Te Reo Māori rapidly growing in popularity, and it seems interest in Māori art is also experiencing a boost.
Yes, it's fantastic. If it's done the right way, though, by which we mean investing in artists and their talent.
Because unfortunately it seems there are some companies taking shortcuts that leave our artists completely shortchanged.
The robberies, as in more than one, happened here at Shane Hansen's house. This was stolen. This could be next.
That's huge. It's rife. It's happening all the time.
Shane says calling the police is a waste of time.
I go through different phases of being annoyed.
It's simple and complicated.
I like to think of it as identity fraud.
Simple because each robbery is an open and shut case. But there's never been a prosecution.
It's against the law to steal a car, but they still get stolen.
Complicated, because this was stolen from Shane, but it's still here.
I wouldn't say I'm particularly angry about it, just a little bit pissed off.
Shane is an artist. Problem is, when he posts his work online, they get copied.
It's a piece of who I am.
Stolen by people far away.
That was the original painting there.
Take this tui Shane created. He then found it on a T-shirt for sale on a website based in Germany.
Like, it's blatant.
It is, yeah, extremely blatant. I'll do a bit of a quick Google, you know.
A few more clicks. This painting.
That one was sort of what started me off against. Oh, come on, man.
It's become duvet covers on an American website.
That's my artwork.
Shane isn't outwardly angry, but don't mistake that for ambivalence or weakness.
It was a lot more mentally and emotionally stressful than I thought it was going to be.
He's talking about the time he discovered this. His artwork, copied, and painted on escape camper vans. Obviously without his permission.
If I'd let it go, it would have haunted me.
So, he took legal action.
This could end up putting us in a real, real bad financial position, but I wasn't going to back down.
A week out from a date at the High Court, escape camper vans settled and offered a public apology. They tell Fairgo they've learned their lesson.
We have made several changes to our business as a result. We therefore urge all businesses using Mr. Hansen's artwork without permission, or any artist for that matter, to either obtain permission, stop it, or acknowledge and address it as we did.
It's not just Shane Hansen though. New Zealand artists are being ripped off every day.
Well, it's really prevalent, you know.
Take Indigenous health organisation Toi Tangata. Their logo ended up on vaping products in the UK. More on that later. Queenstown artist Luca Voigt had her art put on tote bags, and Gabby Malpass started a Pinterest page of her work that's been stolen and sold on overseas websites.
So copyright, who do you go to? You could try the police, but I don't think they're set up to manage that.
Caroline Stone has worked for years helping artists protect their work.
I think half the issue is, that's right, they're out on their own. The other half of the issue is, well, the copyright law says that they have rights, but there's no obvious way to enforce those rights.
The options are find it on your own or get a lawyer.
It's an abuse, you know, it really is.
Copyright lawyer Josie McNaught says artists get worn down.
They've been resigned to it for a long time and then they just become incredibly fed up.
They both say artists need to stand up every time their work gets stolen.
To at least write a letter every time they see it happening, send an email. This is not okay.
Yeah, and it's education.
All right.
Of course, to stop people, you have to find them. First, the World, the company that sold Shane's art on duvet covers, has no phone number.
Thank you for calling Harvard Business Services.
We tried emailing and ran a business listed as having the same physical address.
It's trying to get hold of them.
I don't see them in our system or in the state of Delaware system.
The T-shirt website, which had Shane's art on it, they say it's not their fault.
We allow third parties to upload their designs to our site.
I've seen on your website some shirts where the art's been lifted, stolen, duplicated off someone else.
If you see a design that you want to report, you can click on report design to send it to our legal team.
Then there's the English vaping product called the Haka.
Ooh.
Here it is being reviewed on YouTube.
Wowzers.
It has the same logo as Toi Tangata, the Māori health organisation.
Hi, who's this, sorry?
Acapella.
Acapella Harrison is the owner of AMC Mods. He's based in England. He makes vaping products.
I have not done anything wrong.
and therefore I would fight until the very end to make sure that that's well known.
Acapella says he did see the design on the internet, but he didn't copy it.
I got it from every other influence that I found on the internet.
So did you cut and, you know, did you cut and copy it, or did you modify it?
By freehand, first of all, and then it was put over to a computer, and I'm not interested in a dispute.
Then he threatens if this goes on the news, he'll come after us.
If it is blown up larger than what it ever should be, then I am a tenacious person, being half Māori.
Mm-hmm.
When we get our mindset on something, I will have to follow it through.
It took Shane Hansen many years to get to the place where he can earn a living from creating, so he's certainly not about to start letting people steal from him.
When all I really wanted to do was just be creative, and now that I've got there, you know, I'm not going to let anyone ruin that for me.
Now, in case you're wondering, Toi Tangata's lawyers are looking into Acapella's use of their logo, and Acapella, smart move, says once he's sold out of the disputed product, he's going to relaunch with a new design. Good for him.
Yes, and hopefully a new original design.
Yes.
Now, there is a part you can play in fixing this too, because we are all kind of a part of the problem. So if you see Māori or Pacifica art on a bedspread, a tote bag, a jumpsuit or the like, and it is incredibly cheap, just ask yourself if it's legit, if an artist could possibly be getting paid for this.
And if you're in any doubt, don't buy it. It's quite simple, really.